But what is the solution? What is the program for each part of the society? What is the program for farmers? What is the program for consumers? What is the program for professionals? And what may be the program for the governments? I think that it is to be discussed now. We have seen the food crisis is becoming severe day by day. Every government in the world are not having the solution. The land is reducing by means of the development process. And there is a great impact of the global warming, climate change. So, first solution to control the population. Because the growth of the population is a big challenge. If we will continue the growth of the population of the world human continuously with the increasing rate and your natural resources are limited, are not unlimited, how can we fulfill the demands of the future generation? This is the question. The nature has come on the earth first, and then human being. Why nature has come first and afterward human being? The reason. God has created the nature first to give available all the natural resources to the human being. So God has established the nature first and then sent human being on the earth to fulfill their fundamental demands from the natural resources, fundamental demands. These natural resources which are to be utilized by human being to fulfill daily needs are limited, are not unlimited. One day all the natural resources will finish, no doubt. So it is our spiritual commitment to preserve and protect the natural resources as much as possible. बीच में हिंदी भी बोलूंगा क्योंकि बहुत सारे लोग हिंदी जानते हैं, वो डिमांड भी है. दो तरह के मानव होते हैं, एक मानव का गुट कहता है कि पुनर्जन्म नहीं है, देयर इज नो रीबर्थ एट ऑल. पुनर्जन्म नहीं है, देयर इज नो रीबर्थ, ओनली वन बर्थ, एक ही जन्म है, दोबारा नहीं आना है, इस पृथ्वी पर. सो व्हाट आर द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस वी हैव टू यूटिलाइज इन मैक्सिमम क्वांटिटी. जितने भी प्राकृतिक संसाधन है उसका ज्यादा से ज्यादा मात्रा में हमें उपयोग करना है, चाहे अगले पीढ़ियों के लिए न बचे. मे बी द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेज विल नॉट बी रिस्टोर फॉर फ्यूचर जनरेशन, बट वी हैव टू यूटिलाइज इन मैक्सिमम क्वांटिटी एज मच एज. यह है पाश्चात्य अतिरिक्त भोगवाद. ये हरित क्रांति उसका हिस्सा है. ग्रीन रिवॉल्यूशन इज द पार्ट ऑफ दैट एक्सप्लोरेटर सिस्टम, पार्ट ऑफ दैट फिलोसॉफी व्हिच वांट टू डिस्ट्रॉय द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस स्पीडली. ग्लोबलाइजेशन इज अनादर पार्ट ऑफ दैट सिस्टम. डेवलपमेंट ऑल्सो इज ए पार्ट ऑफ दैट सिस्टम. But there is another philosophy. दूसरे एक विचारधारा है मानव में जो कहती है कि नहीं नहीं हमें पुनर्जन्म है. They claim that there is a rebirth again and again. We have to come on the earth again and again. हमें बार बार आना है, हमें पुनर्जन्म होगा ही. अगर हमें बार बार यहां आना है तो जो प्राकृतिक संसाधन है अगले पीढ़ियों में हमें मिलना चाहिए. व्हाट आर द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस वी हैव टू गेट अवेलेबल इन द फ्यूचर आवर बर्थ. सो दिस फिलोसॉफी सेज नॉट टू डिस्ट्रॉय द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस, वी हैव टू प्रिजर्व नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस एज मच एज पॉसिबल. आप किसके समर्थक हो? Are you supporter of the first part of the society or second part of the society? Right. But you are practicing chemical farming. How you can claim? You are destroying, utilizing maximum commodities in your life. How you can claim? You are not supporter of the first part. You are not supporter of the second part, you are supporter of the first part. The coal is utilized in thermal power stations to create the energy, power, electricity. And the stocks of the coal in the stomach of the earth is going to finish within 20 years. After 20 years, there will be no coal will be available in the stomach of the earth. To raise the growth rate of the economy, China is purchasing maximum minerals from India. Not only China, Brazil, South Africa, India, which are so-called developed countries, are utilizing maximum minerals from the earth for the development process. Minerals are not unlimited, they are limited, and one day all the minerals will be finished. How future generation will be survived? That soil which has given 100 ton of the sugarcane per acre continuously before the Green Revolution, now that land is become barren. No single grass can germinate. By means of the chemical farming, even by means of the organic farming, we have destroyed the fertility of the soil, productivity of the soil. soil cannot be manufactured in the factory. Human being is not the creator. Human being can't create anything in the factory because we are not creator. The God has not given creation power to the human being. Maybe your satellites will go on the Mars. Maybe Indian satellites will go in another universe, maybe. Science is totally developing continuously. But none of the human being can produce, manufacture the rice in the factory. No one scientist can manufacture the feet and pulses in the factory. Because we are not the creator. We are not the creator. We can't create anything in the factory. But we are losing. When you want to produce, manufacture one thing, one commodity, one product, when you insert 100 kg of the raw material in the machine, the end product will come out, and that will be the 99 kg, 98 kg, 95 kg, not 100 kg at all. That means there is a reduction. So we can't create natural resources in the factory. That means soil also cannot be manufactured in the factory. And soil is becoming limited. I have given the figures in the morning session. Sathiyo, when you discuss about the soil, and when evaluate the soil, we are commenting that this soil is a fertile soil, 20 lakh rupees per acre, the price. And this soil is a barren soil, 5 lakh rupees. That means value of the soil is dependent on the fertility of the soil. And fertility of soil is the productivity of soil. That means how much maximum fertility we can create in the soil, our soil will become more productive. That means maximum fertility, maximum production, maximum consumption of the human being, of the food grain. So it is the commitment of every agriculture universities to give that technology to the farmers by which humus will be created continuously. But very strongly should I say that none of the agriculture industry has given any technology to the farmers by which humus is created. But agriculture industry has given the technology to destroy the humus in the soil, destroy the fertility of the soil. That fertility is given to the soil by one product that is called humus. Humus is the bioreactor in the soil, which gives the fertility and productivity to the soil. That means, if you want to increase the fertility of the soil and productivity of the soil, it is our duty to increase the humus content in the soil. Because there is a specific equation, fertility is equal to humus, humus is to fertility. Humus is the target. How this humus is created in the soil? In the humus creation, there are three parties are involved. Number one, the residues of the crop, waste material of the crops, that means straw. Second one, microorganisms. And third one, roots of the crop. I will give some details. It is visible for everybody. Light band karna hai. This is the tree. This is the crop. The leaves are fallen down by means of the leaf fall, natural leaf fall, during the maturation of the plant body. And when the plant is totally matured, and after maturation, entire plant body is fallen down on the surface of the soil. And in rainy season, this straw is decomposed by variable effective beneficial microorganism species and humus is created. That means if you want to create the humus in the soil, in the initial plate, two things are required. Number one, residues of the crop, that means mulching, straw, and microorganisms, culture of the microorganisms. Because microorganisms, when decompose the straw material, residues of the crop, humus is created in the soil. That means, if you want to create the humus in the soil, it is very essential to utilize all the residues of the crop as a mulching on the surface of soil in between two soil, in between two lines of the crop. Otherwise, humus will not be created. An agriculture university has given the suggestion to destroy the straw, to burn the biomass. Why? It is totally against the fundamental science. Why they have suggested to burn the biomass? Because they want not to create the humus in the soil. They want to restrict the humus creation so that the roots will not get available the nutrient. Ultimately, the farmers will commit to purchase the chemical fertilizers, manures from the market, and money will go outside India toward the exploiter system. That was the agenda of the Green Revolution, real agenda. when you purchase seed, maybe hybrid seed or genetically modified seed, BT cotton, from the market, when you purchase chemical fertilizer from the market, when you purchase chemical insecticide, fungicide from the market, when you purchase the tractor and instruments from the market, ultimately money from villages will enter into cities. But in the city, money will not remain. Only commission will remain. And rest of the maximum money will go outside India by means of the manufacturer multinational companies. How much I have calculated? 54 lakh crore rupees we are losing every year to utilize all these commodities, including your agriculture commodity and your individual life commodity also. Unnecessarily. Not required at all. If we will start zero budget natural farming, no hybrid seed and genetically modified seed is required. We have shown BT cotton is giving more product, local cotton is giving more production than BT cotton. You can come and visit the models. We have shown the models are existed. I challenge agri cities. They have to come, they have to visit, and they have to investigate. No fertilizer, no insecticide, no tractor, nothing to be purchased. That means what amount is going outside India, we can restrict. And if this 54 lakh rupees which are going outside India, if you restrict on the border of the India, and we will give the 6 lakh villages in India, every village will get 9 crore rupees every year for their village basic development. What will be the miracle impact in the rural development? What will be the miracle? There should be no any provision in the Indian budget. Not at all, it is not necessary. We do not want single rupees for government of India and state government. Do not want single rupee. They have to only stop the our financial erosion, which is going outside India, and we have to circulate this money in the rural development process. For what purpose? What we can do? This is the question. We can do everything. We can do everything. We will discuss tomorrow about. Straw means residues of the crops. Microorganisms decompose the straw, humus is created, that means microorganisms are also required. The culture of the microorganism. I have investigated which is the best culture of the microorganism. I have tested the dung and urine of the all 36 Indian cow breeds in the laboratory and even in the farm. I have tested the dung and urine of the bullocks in the laboratory. I have tested the dung and urine of the buffaloes in the laboratory. Even I have tested the dung and urine of the Jersey Holstein Western cows in the laboratory. Camel, goats, sheep also I have tested. And at last I found the best culture of the microorganism is local cow dung, Desi cow dung. In 1 gram of the Deshi cow dung, local cow dung, I got minimum 300 crore. That means 3,000 million of the beneficial epitome microorganism in 1 gram of the Deshi cow dung. Just Holstein cow dung, I have not got more than 70 lakh population of the organisms, and maximum your pathogenic bacteria, which are most harmful. Even I have taken the dung of the Deshi cow and dung urine of the Jesse Holstein. I have taken the trials on the crop, and no result has been given by the Jesse Holstein dung and urine on the crop. Because Jesse and Holstein is not a cow, it is another dangerous animal, which is launched in India by that exploiter system. Local Deshi cow, Indian cow, having the species Bos indicus, Jesse Holstein has having a species Bos taurus. Indian cow is belong to Zebu family. Zebu family has 21 characters. I claim openly, none of the character is existed in Jesse Holstein of the cow, 21 characters. None of the characters existed. How the agriculture ministry has the right to claim that Jesse Holstein is a cow? It is not a cow, it is another animal, scientifically approved. Human being want A2 type of the milk, which is having the specific protein, beta casein, prolein, and which is existed in only local Indian cow milk, which is really fantastic amrut for human health. And in the milk of the Jesse Holstein, this type of the beta casein protein is not existed. Another type of the beta casein is existed, which is very harmful. That ammonia acid is very harmful to human being. That is the A1 type of the milk, Jesse Holstein milk. So Jesse Holstein milk is very dangerous for human health. It is scientifically proved. It is scientifically proved. So, Deshi cow dung is the best culture of the microorganism, no doubt. That means two things are required for the humus creation. One is straw, mulching material, and culture of the microorganism, that means the Deshi cow dung, local cow dung. But it is not enough. It is not enough for humus creation, because these microorganisms wants energy for their activities. Without energy, they can't activate, they can't create the humus. Again, I would like to repeat, only the presence of the straw and microorganism is not enough for the humus creation. The microorganisms want the energy for the activities. And that energy is supplied by the roots. Because any green leaf, all the green leaves manufacture food in daytime by means of the photosynthesis process, and that manufactured food is called carbohydrates. Some of the carbohydrates, that means sugar, which is manufactured by the leaves by means of the photosynthesis process, are secreted through the roots and given to the roots, to the microorganisms, fed to the microorganisms. And then microorganisms start to their activities to decompose the straw. That means for the humus creation, there are three things required: straw mulching, second, cow dung, deshi cow dung, local cow dung, and third, roots. In the presence of the roots, only humus is created. Now you are aware about the things. An exploder system. That universal exploder system which has launched green revolution in India. Same exploder system has launched organic farming also in India. Organic farming is not a Swadeshi technology. Organic farming is 100% foreign technology, Videshi technology. I claim openly, organic farming is not a Swadeshi technology. It is not Indian technology. It is 100% foreign technology, Videshi technology.